Good morning, everybody. It's good to see you here this morning for the service of the nails here at White Bluff Methodist. As we get going this morning, a couple of items just for you to be aware of. The first of which is that tomorrow at 1 p.m. we will have the children's event, and then Sunday, Easter Sunday, 9:30 a.m. And we got a good group here today. So if every one of you brings one friend, we already got the sanctuary halfway full. Amen. So let's get that done. Also, in the way of thank yous, as we get started this morning, Miss Melinda Smith is going to be our narrator. Is that the word? And we're so thankful for your ministry with us today. We're also thankful for Lennox, who is going to be hitting a board as we go through, and you will see that more as we get through. Rick and Maddox are live streaming, so welcome to our live stream audience. And then, as always, to our musicians, thank you for your work. We are blessed. Two things. Number one, as we get started today, everybody should have a great big nail in hand, and it is a reminder of what Christ did for us, but it also is an opportunity for you when, as you go through this service, yes, remember, but also when you start to head out on the concrete, drop your nail in a, you know, in an area where you drop them together and hear that thud of the nail on the concrete. And let it be a reminder, you know, of the agony of that Jesus endured, especially as we don't get to the resurrection too terribly quickly. So often I think we do the resurrection, but it's important for us to remember the nails as well. The other thing is that as you go through the breezeway, right after we're done today, you're going to have another great meal. And so you'll want to enjoy that meal. Again, thank you to everyone who has made this week such a success. And we have had some wonderful, wonderful food. So thank you to everyone. Let's join together a word of prayer, and then we'll get started. Almighty God, we thank you so much today for your love and your grace, and we pray your blessing on this service today, that we are a people that are Easter people, but we may not forget the nails. In this moment, may we remember Jesus on the cross and come and kneel before the cross and to say, Lord, that we truly give you our whole hearts and souls. In Jesus' name, amen. Service of the nails.
The Lord be with you and also with you. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. For that which they had not been told them, they shall see. And that which they had not heard, they shall contemplate.
On the Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to clear the narrow street. But the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating there were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head. And he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the way of suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the way of suffering. La Via Dolorosa, triste día en Jerusalén, los soldados le abrían paso a Jesús, mas la gente le acercaba para ver a aquel que llevaba aquella cruz. Por la Via Dolorosa, que es la Via de dolor, vino Cristo Rey Señor, y fue Él quien quiso ir por su amor, por ti y por mí. Por la Via Dolorosa, al Calvario y a morir. The blood that would cleanse the soul of all men made its way through the streets of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the way of suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose
O merciful God, you did not spare your only Son, but offered him up for us all that he might bear our sins upon the cross. Grant that we might so examine ourselves that we realize our own sinfulness, so great as to spiritually crucify him anew. Help us to recognize those nails which we drive into his cross today, and transform us into more faithful disciples in his name. Amen. The nail of pride. As he taught, Jesus said, "Watch out for the teachers of the law. They like to walk around in flowing robes and be greeted with respect in the marketplaces and have the most important seats in the synagogues and the places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses and for a show make lengthy prayers. These men will be punished most severely." O God, help us consider our own pride and where it leads. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our pride hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our pride hurts you.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they
The nail of betrayal. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. "The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him." Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. O God, help us consider how we betray others, how we abandon them in their time of need, how we think of ourselves first. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our acts of betrayal hurt us and create walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our betrayal hurts you.
Were you there when he walked the road alone? Were you there when he walked the road alone? Oh,
the nail of envy. Then the mother of Zebedee's sons came to Jesus with her sons and, kneeling down, asked a favor of him. "What is it you want?" he asked. She said, "Grant that one of these two sons of mine may sit at your right and the other at your left in your kingdom." "You don't know what you are asking," Jesus said to them. "Can you drink the cup I am going to drink?" "We can," they answered. Jesus said to them, "You will indeed drink from my cup, but to sit at my right or left is not for me to grant. These places belong to those for whom they have been prepared by my Father." O God, help us consider how we envy others, how we desire more than we receive, and seek to influence and rule over others. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our envy hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our envy hurts you.
When they stripped him
the nail of indecision. But the chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowd to ask for Barabbas and to have Jesus executed. "Which of the two do you want me to release to you?" asked the governor. "Barabbas," they answered. "What shall I do then with Jesus, who is called the Messiah?" Pilate asked. They all answered, "Crucify him." "Why? What crime has he committed?" asked Pilate. But they shouted all the louder, "Crucify him." When Pilate saw that he was getting nowhere, but that instead an uproar was starting, he took water and washed his hands in front of the crowd. "I am innocent of this man's blood," he said. "It is your responsibility." O God, help us consider how we waver, how we seek to avoid responsibility and to blame others for our actions. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our indecision hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our indecision hurts you.
Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Oh,
the nail of cruelty. Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus into the praetorium and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand. Then they knelt in front of him and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. They spit on him and took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. After they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. Those who passed by hurled insults at him, shaking their heads and saying, "You who are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. Come down from the cross if you are the Son of God." In the same way, the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders mocked him. "He saved others," they said, "but he can't save himself. He's the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe him." O God, help us consider how we are cruel to others, how we malign and slander others, and add to the evil that comes upon them. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our cruelty hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our cruelty hurts you.
Oh,
The nail of hatred. Blessed are you when people hate you, when they exclude you and insult you and reject your name as evil because of the Son of Man. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who are good to you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners do that. And if you lend to those from whom you expect repayment, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners expecting to be repaid in full. But love your enemies, do good to them, and lend to them without expecting to get anything back. Then your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, because He is kind to the ungrateful and wicked. O God, help us consider how we show hate to others, how we fail to care for others and make distinctions among them. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our hatred hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our hatred hurts you.
Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there?
Surely He has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed Him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. He was wounded for our transgressions, and He was buried for our iniquities. Upon Him was the chastisement that made us whole. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid upon Him the iniquity of us all. Father, forgive us, for we know not what we do. We ask all these things through Him who taught us to pray to You, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon us all. So we go forth in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you.